GSK, which is also known as GlaxoSmithKline. Their mission is to help people do more, feel better, and live longer. GlaxoSmithKline is committed to opening up access to their products so that more people can benefit from them. Focused around the delivery of three strategic priorities: increase growth, reduce risk, and improve long-term financial performance. Here's their economic perspective. This is a chart of the stock market table where I got to show you the growth as of 2016. Okay. So, one of their famous aims is aiming to be carbon neutral. They would like to reduce overall carbon footprint by 25% by the year of 2020 versus 2010. They have a carbon neutral chain by 2050. That's what their goal is. The value chain carbon footprint has grown by 2% due to growth in sales of propeller-based inhalers. And they also have an aim of direct carbon emissions declining 2015, bringing the total reduction to 21% over 5 years. They also would like to reduce water impact. By the year of 2020, they want to reduce water impact across the value chain by 20% versus 2010. In 2015, the water target hit reducing usage by 25% since 2010, saved over 15 million more water than we use in a whole entire year. And then they partner with the NGM Resource Institute to develop water saving initiatives in rural Indian communities. So here's some history of GlaxoSmithKline. They started their operations in January 1st of 2001. Before they became GSK, they started in 1750 when Plum Court Pharmacy was established, the forerunner of Allen and Hansberry's in London by Sylvanus Eaton. 1830, John King Smith opened his first drugstore in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. He was joined by his younger brother George to form John King Smith & Co. Thomas Beecham launched the Beecham's Pills business in England in the year 1842. In 1865, Mylan Klein joined Smith and Shoemaker. Then in 1891, Smith, Klein and Company acquired a respected wholesaler, French Richards and Company. That's just some history of the company. In October 1906, the Glaxo trademark was registered, and the launch of Amoxil was in 1972. When scientists at Beecham Research Laboratory discovered the antibiotic amoxicillin. So they're also famously known for the widely used prescription that we take today for most infections. As far as employment opportunities, they were very good with that online. And they have three main areas that they focus on, which is research and development, manufacturing and supply, and sales and marketing. Here's some of the workers. As far as success, they would like to grow a balanced global business. They want to deliver more products of value. They want to simplify the operating model. 82% of Dow Jones Sustainability Index score for economic, environmental, and social performance. And they are 100% markets operating through commercial model. Is that our business? Yeah. And that was it.
Okay, so then. Do you see yourself working for this company?
It's not my field of study. I could see myself working there because it's a healthcare-based company, and that's our major is healthcare management, but I don't see myself working there. The employment opportunities are like more for people that wanted to go